Biraz uğraşır. Herhalde, herhalde. தைப்பூச திருநாளும் வருகின்றதே, தைப்பூச திருநாளும் வருகின்றதே. காவடிகள் உலகெங்கும் உலவுகின்றனவே, காவடிகள் உலகெங்கும் உலவுகின்றனவே. பக்தரில் காலடிகள் சமுத்திரம் போல் தெரிகின்றனவே. ஆண்டவன் செல்லில் ஆண்டவன் கருணை கடல் போல் விரிகின்றதே. செல்திலாண்டவன் கருணை கடல் போல் விரிகின்றனவே. எள்ளளவும் மனம் ஈந்தளவும் நம் மனம் ஈந்த கொள்ளை கொள்ளுவான் முருகல் நோ மனத்தை. எள்ளளவும் நம் மனம் ஈந்த கொள்ளை கொள்ளுவான் முருகல் நோ சித்தத்தை. முருகா என்று அழைப்போர்க்கு ஓம் எனும் பிரணவோபதேசம் செய்வான். கண்ணின் இமையாக மேனியில் கவசமாக, கண்ணின் இமையாக மேனியில் கவசமாக காத்து ரட்சிக்கும் கார்த்திகையின் புதல்வன் சரணம் என தஞ்சம் புகுந்தே. சரணம் என தஞ்சம் புகுந்தே. முருகா முருகா நீயே சர்வமோ, நீயே சகலமு நீயே நானோ ஒன்றே சுகம் அதிலே அமைதி எங்கும் சாந்தி ஓ சுப்ரமண்யோஹம் ஓ சுப்ரமண்யோஹம் ஓ சுப்ரமண்யோஹம். Friends, nothing spreads like silence. Only when silence spreads throughout the world, you will find peace, you will find bliss spreading throughout the universe. But the world is silence. But the people, but the particularly humankind has created a lot of noise instead of sound. A tree cannot create an unfamiliar sound. It has to create its own sound. All the animals, every bird creates its own sound. But humankind creates very unsavory and unfamiliar and not required, unrequired sounds. Noise, I call it. So they want to find peace within this noise. How do they get it? Between every word there is silence. Between every letter there is silence. And when the starting of the letter and ending of the letter there is silence. But without this, if man travels in sound and noise, the silence is missing. And man fears, because silence, initially we call it as it's something like Rudrabhumi, Smashana Amaidi. We call it peace, we equate it to Smashana. But do you think that without that, what else you are? So don't be afraid by the Shabdas. We create ourselves, Smashana, Rudra, money, matter, materialism. It's a better sound at least. At least in this there is less fight. Then fight with regard to money, matter, materialistic relationship, materialism. In the work called Brahma Sutra, it is told that there are two ways a soul travels towards the worlds. Unless he is a Jivan Mukta, he travels in two ways. The normal human beings who are bound by Papa and Punya, they go to Yamaloka. For them there is not even a branded release. There is no brand that there will be a release, because they will enjoy either hell or heaven and come back. But those who worship or idolize or do rituals or meditate or do prarthana, they are also, unless they are getting rid of ahankara and they get rid of their ego and dvandva, the attachment, they also travel only up to the Chandraloka, and by that they mean that they will live in their respective fields of attachment and they will come back to earth. But those who are worshippers of Saguna Brahman and one who has realized in his heart that his Ishtadeva is Sarvasva, such people enjoy the same benefits as Nirguna Jivan Mukta, Nirguna Upasaka. It's told that when a Nirguna Upasaka called Jivan Mukta gets released on this very earth, these people enjoy the same type of life because they think that God alone runs their lives. And then afterwards they go through the rays of sun to the Brahma Loka, they are guided. There they identify themselves with the Vishnu, Shiva, or whoever they have worshipped. And at the end of Kalpa, when the Brahmaloka dissolves, they go back and into their element, what you call, whatever it is, and they don't come back. They enjoy a similar non-returnable state of aikyata as a Jivan Mukta enjoys. So this means that the lesser mortals, including the karma, jnana, bhakti people who have not left ego, they don't go up to Brahmaloka. The clarification was those who go to Brahmaloka, whether they return or not. I was trying to tell that Brahmaloka is totally different, but this is only a part of Chandraloka, a part of imagination that these people enjoy and come back. So there are two different things. So, yeah, Saguna Upasaka, who has realized this devata in his heart, and Saguna Upasaka, who is still in the stage of Upasana. There is clearly a distinction. These are all not my words. It's Brahma Sutra. And Chandraloka, they mean that a part of mental transit. Just like transit, you know, you go and stay somewhere and go back to your destination. You go to Vaikuntha, stay for some time, come back to earth. Not the real Vaikuntha, where in the Brahmaloka also there is a bigger thing, where you identify with Vishnu, and that ends. Whereas these people enjoy a sort of togetherness in the parapsychological or mental levels, and they come back to earth. So that was the difference told in the Brahma Sutra. So more details are discussed about the return of the soul and how they enter into a garbha and all those things. That we have already discussed. So having known this, this kind of knowledge, I thought, at least because it is Shastra, even children should be educated in this. They should be given a little knowledge about all this. Because as they grow, they will be devoid of their possessiveness, and they will be acting rightly, because their mind will get shaped. The whole world makes you fight. You fight with your own mind and hold what should be rejected and reject what should be held. I'm talking about the general public. So whole life, if they start thinking at the end of their life, they would have found out that they were in the process of rejection, but they were holding. Nowadays, there is a great introspection going on throughout the world. Even though there is a misunderstanding about the soul's existence, Atma's existence, but the introspection goes on. Even the film star, actresses, would you like to drive alone? Yes, I would like to drive alone. Why do you drive alone? Now I can hear to Vishnu Sahasranama, I can recite it, then I can put off, and I can then think about my inward journey, you know, I can introspect. Everyone has started talking about this inward journey, introspection, correcting myself. In those fields we can't think of, they will say that, no, I like fun, I like this, I like that. Nowadays they have also started telling that, I want to introspect, I want to be alone, I want to think about myself, my activities, what I am doing. The words are theirs, not mine. What I am doing in this world. So, it's a good sign that they have started going inward. Many people, those who pose as if they are not introspecting, they are only posing. They are also in introspection. For Indians, the models are American actors, actresses. They have also started thinking, and they say that the introspection and the Hinduism, Buddhism, they are very much attracted by. The sheep may be Indian, shepherd should be a foreigner. So in each house you find a German shepherd. Indian sheep we are all, so for us a German shepherd is seriously, many people are having it in India. And what other point we need clarification for? Any points? going to tell. So all your education and training should lead you to character, courage and confidence. If the character is not there, there is no courage. People will be afraid. If there is no courage, there will be no confidence. And the artificial confidence and so-called courage by negating character leads to disturbances in the world. So at some time it will be put into check. That's why I told that some scientists are trying to find out whether our by reordering or readjusting in our bodily system, cells and all, can we live for 1,000 years and all, 2,000 years and all. We are trying to find out. But where was the necessity? You living itself, they have not done anything. By living for 1,000, 2,000 years, what is the achievement? But if it's going to be against nature, nature will immediately come and put a check. So that's why I always say that align with nature, be friendly with nature, then scientific revelations are so easy. If you are going to test nature, then it's difficult. It's just a story, but I don't know. We'll take it seriously. I am going to tell you that. Vyasa hears somewhere that Kashi is a very important Patna. We don't know whether the same Vyasa is there. There were hundreds of Vyasas in the lineage. But the story quotes one Vyasa. Vyasa hears somewhere that Kashi is a Patna, Kashi is a town where people are respected, Brahmins are respected, and whoever goes, they will be given food, they will be given sanmana, they will be given upachara, they will be respected. This Vyasa hears. Mr. XYZ Silk, Varadarajan bought one silk sari, andre. We should not mistake that from Kanjivaram, Varadaraja Perumal came and bought one silk sari, just because it is written. So there may be so many Vyasas that way. So he comes without getting anything, you know, he just comes free hand, with two hands free, with all his disciples into Kashipatna. Then almost all houses he goes on katkatang, seeing him, someone does some excuse, someone tells that he is in pati service, someone says something else, and nowhere food is served. Our friend is Vyasa and his disciples. He goes to Annapurna temple, there also the temple is closed. It was not the time for temple to open. 2 days he goes on and they were almost about to faint, murcha, swoon. So this is the story, I'm telling you correctly what is mentioned. So after 2 days he was about to give shapa on the Kashipatna. He takes his hand like this. And immediately one lady comes and says, no, relax, having waited so far, why don't you trust tomorrow? Just one day more. Then next day also he waited and there was no response, no one comes with food. And immediately he gets very angry, what is this? Takes his hand and about to give shapa, give curse on the Kashipatna. Only that lady came out and told, come on, I'll wash your feet. She washed all Vyasa and his disciples' feet, took them inside and gave them food, sumptuously. Then they were given good silk shawls, all the sanmanas, all the gauravas, all the honor. Then Vyasa told them, why did not you do 2 days back? Yeah, the same thing you are ready to do. Why you didn't do that time when I came first time to your place? Then she told, any ego is banned here. There is Annapurna or Lord Vishwanatha. It is banned here because you are going to test us whether Kashi will feed you, Kashi will respect you, Kashi will give you honors. With this kind of testing methods in your mind you came, so you were not considered. Now you are about to die. If you have not done shapa also, you are about to die. We thought that you are going to lose your yoga, we fed you. And now that you are full, that you are going to bless the city. Bless the city and now tell to the world that don't test God. Lose the ego. The sign of learning is not having any attachment with ego. So it's a lesson for all. If you would have thought that Annapurna will, with lot of praise for Annapurna, you would have come not to test, then you would have received, you've been received with royal honors on the first day itself. So you find in the story of even later people like in Mahabhakta Vidya about all the bhaktas also. Those people have left their not last rupees also. They were given royal honors. So what is important is holding, possessing and attachment with ego. We have to lose. So I always say, be in solitude, don't have loneliness. Loneliness is a mistake, feeling of loneliness. Solitude you enjoy, wherever you are put, you are in solitude. What is solitude? Be self, in the self. Loneliness means you are left, I am alone, I'll do a lot of crooked works, my mind will start thinking. So don't become lonely ever in life, but be in solitude. Solitude? Svananda. As far as possible, take some name in the mind always. Name of God. Name of God. Nama japa vanna athwa nama vanna repeat martha hogi manasinalli. That does not give you mindfulness of many other wrong thinking or right thinking, whatever you call it. When you come back to life, coming back to wakefulness, thank God that you are connected with your brain and one more day you are going to enjoy in this world. It's something like spacecraft, you know. Going into space is fantastic, but landing is very difficult. So once they are landing, they feel happy. They come back to earth. They thank. Similarly, you are getting connected for one more day of experience with the created world, so you are thanking. Throughout the day, as far as possible, recite some name. Other points don't take into great details. Things which has to come in your friend, it will come. Which has to run away, will run away. Which has to transact with you, transact. All these things are by the way. ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ಯಾರು ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಸ್ಪಂದಿಸಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪಂದಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಏನು ನಡೆಯಬೇಕೋ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ನೇಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೈಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಲೀಪ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸೀ ಹೌ ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಡೇ. Are you happy with your mental thinking for the day? Both the ways you praise the Lord, praise your God of Ishta, and say that let every day be a very, very, very good day for me and get me connected to you. Whatever way, don't feel bad, but request. Put a request, not eternally, but a sincere request, I can say, to God. Let me be connected to you and let me have a decently good life with good experiences, and that will be given. Then life's experiences become a great joy to celebrate.
Yeah, whatever you said, I got a question after that. I'm happy, I think I'm doing right. And the time of sleep, I am doing whatever I have to do perfectly.
Very good, very good.
And I want to be better tomorrow. All okay. That is fine. But how do we consider the external, whatever is external to us?
That's what everything will come
and report to you. Don't gather about it as long as you take the name of God within.
you attend to everything normally. Normally, whatever your sense says to you.
Let's say I'm angry with someone and I'll go in my own way. I will not talk to that person and I will do whatever I want. And I feel it is right for me.
If it's right, it's right.
But I'm punishing the other person also.
Then you should not have two opinions. Either hopefully you should be like this or you should be. If you are seeing the other always, even a child to be told something, you will feel very bad, isn't it? So, either hold to this view or that view. Then you become a sannyasi, like, just like if a scorpion bites you. Stings you and we hear all those stories, you know. It's its duty to sting and it's my duty to save it. But if you feel the sting and if there is a general intelligence, which I always say, we should use to just find the gap and come out of it. Unless we are sure that we have taken the policy of punishing oneself. So that is a sannyasic lakshana, where you consider others, you find and then take on yourself. Sannyasis is very good. For all others, you want to deal materialistically, and as far as possible, be right. They will have to get connected to you if you are right. For sannyasis, they can't say they are right. They have to go, went to others' feelings. They will have to act as per society's view. Because they are not having their opinion. Mind is not there. But for a person who is in the Grihastha Dharma, working Dharma, he should always feel that he is right. So, both the ways don't... So don't want the other person to be angry, first request orally itself. Don't be angry, I will shout at you. Nowadays it's easier. Everyone is very plain. So, you can just say that now I am going to shout for 10 minutes. Hear and forget it, if you can. So that you are also free and the other person also heard. And if he finds wisdom in what you are saying, then he will say that, hey, okay, I will get corrected. If he finds that something has to be told to you, then say that don't tell now. When I am in the mood to receive you, I will ask you to tell. Then you tell. At that time, so you can avoid all these things. It's better to talk it over instead of distending relationships with people who are aimed at. I think it's easier because all the people are so much related. Even if it's a stranger, I think they understand if they feel that we are right. Is it all right?
Yeah.
Thank you. It's easier also. But never, your mind feels always right. You feel that your anger is right, your anger is right. Don't go away from that. But if you consider that the other person is going to suffer, no one suffers. Unless we put them in very, very, very different positions. If they don't get food, if they don't get... Only those things are suffering. This anger and all nowadays over it. In European style they are there. In India, I think they have left all this. Because they have been trained to receive anger. And selective hearing. Using veto power. They will hear. So whenever they want, they will hear. Even the mother-in-laws. Whenever they should not go back to their, what is called, sills. Dills. They don't have dills. Daughter-in-law. They will not hear. Even if the daughter-in-law shouts, silently go. Whenever she is, Dill is alone,
whenever this mill wants to give, mill's growing. At that time, even a small word will be heard differently.
Vasudeva.
Vasudeva
sutam devam,
sutam devam
kamsachanuram,
kamsachanuram
mardanam,
mardanam
devaki,
devaki
paramanandam,
paramanandam
krishnam vande,
krishnam vande
jagadgurum,
jagadgurum
shruti smriti,
shruti smriti
puranaanam,
puranaanam
alayam,
alayam
karunalayam,
karunalayam
namami,
namami
bhagavat
padam
shankaram,
shankaram
lokashankaram,
lokashankaram
shankaram,
shankaram
shankaracharyam,
shankaracharyam
keshavam,
keshavam
badarayanam,
badarayanam
sutrabhashya,
sutrabhashya
kritau vande bhagavantau,
punapunah
ishvaro,
ishvaro
gururatmeti,
gururatmeti
murtiveda,
murtiveda
vibhagine,
vibhagine
vyomavat,
vyomavat
vyaptadehaya,
vyaptadehaya
dakshinamurtaye namaha,
dakshinamurtaye namaha.
Purnamada,
purnamada
purnamidam,
purnamidam
purnat,
purnat
purnamudachyate,
purnamudachyate
purnasya,
purnasya
purnamadaya,
purnamadaya
purnameva avasishyate,
purnameva avasishyate.
Om shanti,
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 shanti.
Thank you.